Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about the fecal fat stain. So this is often done by the doctor or as part of the stool analysis to determine if your body's digesting fats properly. So, you know, you will eat typically up to about 100 grams of fat for 2 or 3 days before the test, and then a stool sample's taken to determine, you know, what the fat content's like. This is a especially relevant test for people who've had a gallbladder removed, or have IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, or any kind of like chronic digestive problem. But also it will show a doctor if you've got pancreatitis, you know, if potentially you've got many different types of, you know, conditions there. As I mentioned, IBS, IBD, pancreatitis. We really need to know this. It's important to understand if your body's digesting fats properly. If it's not, you're in for a lot of problems, because remember also, fat-soluble vitamins get broken down and absorbed through this pathway as well. So if you're passing it too much fat through the stool and not absorbing it, it can lead to deficiencies, fatigue, and a whole raft of different problems. So this is normally done as part of a comprehensive stool analysis, but often it can be done by your GI doctor as a small standalone test, particularly if the gallbladder is being removed. A good thing to do yourself regularly is to look in the toilet bowl to see if there's any fat floating on the water after a bowel motion, because that can alert you also to problems. And sometimes just taking a digestive enzyme for a few weeks or a few months can sort the problem out. Sometimes you might need to be on it longer, and other times you may need to change your diet. But that gives you a bit of an insight into the fecal fat test. Thanks for tuning in.